Aunt, don't you want to come with us at the site so you'll see how our operations are going?
Oh, after the sudden cave-in that happened there the last time, I'd rather not, Gael. Besides, your mommy will be there to monitor the operations. Right, Miranda?
Of course. And it's muddy down there. You're not properly dressed for it. You might get dirty. You might even spoil your good image, madam.
Well, that won't be a problem, Miranda. That's why you're here. That's your expertise. Right? You like cleaning up the mess?
That's why you should thank me. Your image is clean, right?
So, I've been meaning to talk to you, Gael. I have several plans for your birthday. I wanted to show to you to them today so you can decide how you want to celebrate it.
No need for a party, Sam. I want to spend it differently this year. I want to celebrate it peacefully and away from everyone.
Then celebrate with us. Just family. Our family, your family. We can also take that chance to discuss your future in politics. Because Salvador told me that you're planning to run for town councilor in the coming local elections.
Actually, Aunt, I haven't made up my mind about that yet.
Then we will help you decide. We also need to talk about how we can help you with your campaign. We fully support you, Gael. Especially Samantha.
So why exclude us, Gael? Just a simple dinner. Together with the Del Mundos. Nothing grand.
Sorry, but not this weekend. I have plans.
Well, you're here, so let's eat. I hope you don't mind, but I did take the liberty of cooking something.
Hey, boy. What's with you? I know you're hungry, so okay. Come here.
Are you mad?
Do I have a reason to be mad?
Because I didn't agree with what Reynoso wanted?
You know, I don't really get it. I don't get why you turned him down.
It's simple. I just don't trust him, and that's just about it.
You don't trust him? He's a good person. He's the reason why you were able to return to the country.
Sander, not everyone who helps us is a good person. Just because he helped us does not mean he's good already. I'm pretty sure that he only helped us for his own selfish ambitions. And that's it.
How can you be sure?
I've worked in the government for so long. So I'm familiar with every kind of monster who works there. Reynoso's no different. I know that he only wants to help us because he wants to get ahead of Salvador. But the truth is, they're no different at all. He's just a dirty politician. And so, tell me right now, what exactly is the point of bringing down that Salvador del Mundo, if only to be replaced by his clone?
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, happy birthday. Happy birthday to you. All right. There, make a wish. What was your wish?
I didn't make any.
But why?
My wish already came true.
Oh, just hold on. Of course, Father and Grandma didn't forget this.
Oh, wow.
They made this for you, and that then helped too.
Wow, tell your family I'm grateful. They shouldn't have. Wait, do we have rice there?
Yes, here. Oh, just wait.
These are noodles.
It's for you. Just take it.
Photos of me. Anna, it's pretty.
I'm so sorry, Gael. It's all I could afford. I don't have much money. It's really cheap.
Anna, it doesn't matter how much your gift costs, okay? I will love anything you give me.
My, 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 you're flattering me right now. I'm your girlfriend already.
I'm serious, okay? Every year I always celebrate my birthday with a big party. But in spite of those, there was always something missing. I think that this is my happiest birthday.
Why don't you get that first?
Okay.
Go on.
Mom.
Gail, where are you?
Why'd you call?
If you're not busy, can you swing by your godfather's office now?
We have a problem.
What's the problem?
We'll just discuss about it when you get here.
Mom, it's my birthday today. I took the day off.
I know. I'm sorry, Gael. But this is an emergency.
Your godfather needs you.
Okay.
So what happened?
It's urgent. I need to go to the office.
Really? Go ahead. You should hurry.
Anna, no. I can't leave you alone in this place.
All right, I'll go with you. Let's pack this first.
It's so dark. So, this is the emergency, huh?
Gael, you're with someone?
Yes. By the way, everyone, this is Anna.
Hello, Anna.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi.
I fired her as your nurse before. Why is she here?
Mom, Anna is not here as my nurse. Anna is here as my girlfriend.
I thought we'd surprise you, but it turns out it was you who surprised us.
And I told you not to bother, right? You didn't have to trouble yourselves. But still, thank you for this.
You look very familiar, dear. You were also taken as a hostage with Gael, am I right about that?
Yes, ma'am. I was also his nurse.
Look at you. From nurse to girlfriend, real quick. I think you gave in rather too soon, dear.
Isn't that what love is about, Mom? No one knows when or what time it'll strike, right? If it hits you, it hits you hard.
Anyway, it's so typical of you, Gael. You were attached to your nanny back then, and you wouldn't leave her side. Some habits die hard.
Being a nanny is an honorable work. Because whenever you can't spend time with your children, they're the ones who act as their second mothers.
Oh my gosh. I'm so sorry.
No, it's all right.
I'm so sorry.
I'm sorry, ma'am.
I'm really sorry. Sorry.
It's okay. Leave it to them.
Do you need to go to the ladies' room?
I'll go with you. Excuse us.
Anna, excuse me.
Here, let me help you.
No, ma'am, it's fine. I'm all right. I can do it, thank you. Okay.
Actually, it's really my fault. Oh my gosh, I'm so sorry. I'm so clumsy.
Ma'am, about me and Gael.
You don't have to explain, okay?
It's just that
I admit, I got a little attached to Gael. After all, out of all the guys I've met and known before, he's always been the better choice. But he's not my only option, you know? I'm sure I'll find someone better for me. Actually, I was surprised. Because when Gael courted me, I made him wait.
How can you be so insensitive, Gael? How can you do that to Samantha? She thought of you all the time while she was still in Switzerland. And she comes home to this?
Samantha and I broke up a long time ago. We already talked about it before I courted Anna, and she's okay with it.
Oh? Gael, I know that Anna's an excellent nurse. But then, why did you choose her? And what would people say about it? Your girlfriend now was just your former nurse?
Anna works an honest job, Mom. She's a good person with a decent family. So you think I'd care about what people would say about me and Anna? And why don't you get to know her first before you judge her?
You know, men, they love challenges.
But time doesn't decide whether a person truly loves you or not. And we love each other.
Anna, don't get me wrong, okay? Actually, you're so lucky. While Gael is destined for great things. Since we were young, he always wanted to follow my dad's footsteps. He could even become the president someday. But he has one weakness.
What is it?
His heart. When he falls in love, he forgets everything else. He always puts his heart first, before his dreams. But I'm not blaming you, okay? It's just that I'm worried. Lately, it seems that he's losing his drive again. We don't want that for him, do we? Well, personally, if I were to make a choice, if I'd follow my heart rather than my dream, I would rather make sure that that person is worth it.
How long have you known this girl? For all you know, she's only with you so she could make it big sooner or later. She doesn't deserve you.
You know what? If you won't give Anna a chance, I think it's best that we leave right now.
Wait, let's calm down. We shouldn't talk about this here. We're having a birthday dinner. There's a right time for this kind of matter, okay? But not now. Let's enjoy the party.
Anna, let's go. Your father might be worried now.
Wait, what about your dinner? You haven't eaten your dinner at all.
Well, good father, thank you and sorry, but we have to go. Let's go.
I'm sorry.
Anna, are you okay? I know you heard what we were talking about back there.
It's okay. I honestly can't blame them. I'm sure that they were surprised to see me there. Besides, I know they want someone better for you.
Anna, don't ever say that. It has nothing to do with the relationship.
Oh, Samantha told me what you've always wanted since you were young, to become a politician.
That was then, way before I met you. That was what my mother wanted from me. I know that when I become a politician, they'll always tell me what to do anyway, from what I'll wear to the woman I should end up with. And now I won't allow them to decide on whom I will love.
But Gael, I don't want to stop you from choosing to live your dream. I want you to reach for that dream.
Listen to me, Anna. Don't give up on us.
Don't worry, Gael. It'll never happen. I'll always be here for you. I'll always support you in your dreams.
Here is my girlfriend.
I'll always be here for you. I'll always support you in your dreams. So that's what happened? Gosh, I'm really sorry if I kept teasing you. I just didn't know that you and Gael were going through something like that. And well, I thought those intense things only happened in soap operas.
Come on, it's all right. It's my fault for pursuing my feelings for him.
I can't believe that that family's so judgmental, Anna. But just cheer up. What more can they ask for, really? You're so pretty, you're intelligent and caring. So what more do they want?
Money. But of course I don't have that. Of course I'm not like them. You're filthy rich.
Oh my goodness, don't say that. I mean, if Prince Harry was able to marry an ordinary woman, what makes you think that Gael wouldn't? So stop belittling yourself.
Hey. Who's belittling you? Here.
I'm sorry about last night, Godfather. I just didn't want Anna to get hurt any further.
I can't blame you for that, since your mom and your Aunt Hillary just won't stop talking about her. Okay. About that Anna. Are you sure about her?
I really love Anna, Godfather. And that's what's important, right?
Come here. You know, Gael, when you're a politician, you have to really choose the people you let into your life very, very carefully. And your Aunt Hillary? I chose her because I love and trust her with all my life. But I also know that she can help me reach all of my dreams. So if ever I become president, I know that she'll make a great first lady, and you. How can Anna help you reach all of your dreams?
Anna is a good person, and she supports me. And if I ever enter politics, I want her by my side. She's part of my plans now.
For now?
No, Godfather. Anna is now part of all of my dreams.
Okay. Okay.
Anna, I'm your father. So what's wrong, huh? Do you have a problem?
Father, this will be over before you know it. I just don't know how I can get along with Gael's family and the Del Mundos.
So that's it? My goodness. Just be yourself, okay? Because the real you is very easy to fall for. You and Gael didn't get along at first, remember? But he fell in love with you. So once his family gets to know you better, I'm sure that they'll warm up to you.
Oh, I wish it were that simple, Father. I mean, they're really a rich and prominent family. So I'm pretty sure that Mrs. Ojeda has never thought Gael would date someone like me.
Hey, so what if he's dating you? Your past doesn't matter, as well as your status in life. What matters is what's inside here. We may not be rich, we don't have a name that everybody knows, but we're good people. See? We don't step on others. That's not our doing. So, don't you think you're beneath Gael? Because we raised you well, Anna. You're a good woman. You're a good person. In fact, Gael's so lucky to have you.
bullseye. Great job.
What are you doing here?
I know you come here only when you're in a bad mood. Maybe you need someone to talk to? Gael, I know last night was difficult for you. It happened on your birthday.
If I'd known things would turn out that way, I shouldn't have come. Sam. About me and Anna. I hope it doesn't bother you. The last thing I want to do is hurt your feelings.
I told you, right? More than anything, I'm still your friend. So if that's what makes you happy, I'll still fully support you. And I'm on your side. I'm with you and Anna.
Thank you, Sam. If only my mom and Aunt Hillary felt the same way.
I know they'll understand it someday. And I'm willing to help. Look, I'm throwing this party next weekend. Our friends and our parents' friends are all going to be there. You and Anna should go together. That way people will know who she is.
I'll think about it.
Gaeli, believe me, you'd want to be there. And once the public finds out who Anna is, your mom won't be able to do anything about it. Okay? Okay. Great. So, I'll be the one to call Anna, and I'll invite her personally, and I'll make sure she looks fabulous for the party.
Okay.
Now you're smiling.
Just wait for me.
Well, I tried talking to Gael, but I really can't change his mind. He's really infatuated with this nurse.
That's the least of our problems. Somebody called me. It's confirmed that Reynoso already has a witness against us.
Who is it?
We don't know anything for now. So we have yet to find out what the witness knows against us.
What if he's serious about calling a press conference to ruin my name?
If he's serious about it, I'll be the first to know.
Well, I won't wait around. I won't wait for that witness to come forward and cause us trouble. Never. I won't let that Reynoso win.
There she is.
Thank you, ma'am. Anna!
Ma'am.
There you are. What, ma'am? Stop calling me ma'am. Just call me Sam. So, Gael mentioned to me a while ago that you work here. And I was in the neighborhood, so I just wanted to say hi. And to personally invite you to our upcoming event. Has Gael already told you? About the dinner?
Oh, yes. But I'm not made to socialize with the rich.
Anna, what was that? You're Gael's girlfriend now. Therefore, you should get used to interacting with our friends.
But I feel like
I actually have a great idea. We can get ready together, just before dinner. I can be your personal stylist.
You'll do that?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I wouldn't want to impose.
Gael's my best friend. So I don't mind doing it. Yes? Great! So I'll see you on Saturday then?
Thanks a lot.
All right. Bye.
Bye, Anna.
Anna, I don't know if you're aware of my plans with Salvador. But still, I need you out of Gael's life. If he can't stay away from you, then I'll find a way, any way, to get rid of you.
Ma'am, I'm on my way now.
So you're Anna. I've heard so much about you. Welcome to the new Del Mundo mansion. You should be honored, because you're one of the first visitors of this place. They just moved here.
Anna! I'm glad you're here. Gracia?
Yes, Miss Samantha?
Can you please send her up? Don't get lost, okay? Our mansion's a bit huge, you know.
Miss Samantha, here she is. Come in.
This house is huge. I told you. This house is a palace.
Oh my gosh, Gracia! I told you to remove the pictures, right?
I'm sorry, Miss Samantha. It slipped my mind.
Oh, no. It's okay.
Anyway. Welcome to my room.
You have a lot of jewels.
That is my jewelry collection. It was I who made all of those. Oh, hey! Anna! Be careful! Those are expensive. But go ahead. Just tell me who among those you want to wear tonight.
Who?
Mm-hmm. Well, there's George, Steve, Tyler, Archie.
Wait, your jewelry all have names?
Of course, because to me, crafting a jewelry is like making love. I give my heart and my soul into it. That is why every piece is special and unforgettable. Especially my favorite piece.
And this is Miss Samantha's favorite.
That is pretty. What's the name of this one?
That's Gael. Oops. I'm sorry. But I hope you don't mind. Because I'm wearing Gael tonight.
It's okay. It's just jewelry.
Okay then. Let's fix you up. Sit down, Anna. Go ahead. So, you don't use keratin, do you?
Keratin? So who's keratin?
She doesn't know it.
Anna. Well, keratin is a hair treatment. Because your hair looks dry and dull and frizzy. I don't think combing it will be enough to fix it.
It's okay. Don't worry about my hair. I'll do it. I can fix it myself.
No, don't bother. That's why Gracia's here. Gracia will take care of you, right?
Why me?
Well, I can't do it.
I'll do it. I'll fix her up. Okay?
Good. Now, don't worry, Anna. I will make sure that you will look great tonight.
Thank you, Samantha.
For what?
I admit that at first I thought you were really snobbish, but then, now that I've gotten to know you, I think you're very nice.
Well, you also look nice and kind. You know what, Anna? Given a different circumstance, I think we can be friends. Maybe like sisters?
Well, actually, you deeply remind me of my sister.
You have a sister?
Yes, but then we got separated. And you? Do you have a sibling?
Oh, no. I'm an only child. And I like it that way. Because you know what, Anna? If there's one thing that I hate, it's having competition.
Oh, really? You know, that's where you're wrong. It's nice to have a sibling. My sister and I were very close to each other before. I never went anywhere without her. I was behind her. I used to always defend her.
And here it is. Look, this is going to be your dress. It's personally handpicked by me.
I'll wear that?
Mm-hmm.
Wait, hold on. This dress is too pretty. Isn't it too much?
Come on, Anna. Don't be silly. That's just a simple dress, and you'll just be borrowing it, right? It's not like you'll steal it. Go ahead.
Try it on.
Fit it.
Come on.
Grasha, show her the dressing room.
Yes, Miss Amantha. I'll take care of it.
I will schedule a press conference very soon, okay? So have your testimony ready now. I'm having a legal team look at it. I'm having my PR team look at it. Will you be ready by tomorrow?
I'm so sorry, Senator. But I won't do that just yet.
What is it now?
Because I want to be very sure about it. I only want to speak out once we have gathered enough evidence against Salvador, once we're sure we have him cornered.
Celeste, we don't have much time for that. Everyone is waiting now for my exposé, and once we put your statement out there, the police will then investigate.
But Senator, you and I both know Salvador. He has a lot of connections. We cannot just let anyone, even the police, conduct this kind of investigation against that man.
Okay, I'll give you what you want. We'll just hire an investigator to help you out.
Sir, it's not needed. We can manage now.
We can?
Didn't you just say we can't trust anyone?
Well, if that's what you want, what matters now is that you move quickly. Salvador knows I have information against him, and surely he will do everything to stop me and shut me up.
Stop looking at me like that. You're making me nervous.
You don't have to worry because you're the most beautiful girl in this party. And you're here with...
the most handsome guy here?
Just a party?
Oh, okay. All right. The most handsome guy in the universe.
But seriously, I'm so lucky to be standing beside you this evening. Shall we? Please stop worrying. I'll introduce you. By the way, this is Mara, and this is...
Sam, why did you bring that low-life woman here? You even invited her to your own party? I mean, what's up with you?
I'm just getting back what is mine, Mom. And right after this party, she won't be able to show her face again.
Oh, hi!
All right. Have a seat.
Excuse me, Sorgel. We have prearranged seats here. You'll sit there, and Anna, you'll be seated here, okay?
Oh, okay.
Grasha, you know what? I'm sure Sam will understand.
Okay.
Let's go.
Is that okay?
She won't mind. Girlfriend,
hi, hello.
Great party.
Thanks. It's actually Sam's party.
Oh, yeah, it's really nice.
That's right.
Gael, meet my girlfriend.
Hi, so how are you?
You have a girlfriend?
Well, I'm doing fine. We need to go. Okay, bye.
We've been together for a while.
How long have you been together?
3 years.
Wow, 3 years. It's quite a while now.
Hello, Anna.
Hi, Mrs. Ojeda.
Is everything okay?
Well, yes.
Is there something you want to say? I've been noticing you keep looking at me.
Oh, no, ma'am, nothing.
Are you sure?
I'm sure.
Mom!
Gael! I was just saying hello to Anna. You look so beautiful, dear.
Thank you, ma'am.
Gael, you shouldn't leave Anna alone in this party, since she's not familiar here. Is everyone treating you nicely, Anna?
Yes, ma'am.
Good. Just let me know if anyone doesn't treat you well around here. I will put them in their place.
Mom, I'm sure Anne is fine. But thank you for your concern.
Of course I'm concerned. Anne is your girlfriend. She's part of the family now. And family members always have each other's backs. Right, Anna?
That's right.
I'll see you later.
You hungry?
Hmm?
Let's eat first. I'll get us a plate. Actually, I'm not hungry, so you should eat first.
No, I'm all right.
No, you should eat. Come on.
I don't know whatever you're up to, Anna. But there's no place for you in our lives. You'll only ruin all my plans for Gael. You won't last long, I swear. I'll make sure of it. Why are you so worried now? When you could have stopped Anna from going there.
I don't want to do that, Mother. Well, it's been a while since I've seen her happy. I'm just worried about her. You know well how things turned out when Gael first introduced Anna to his family, right? Now might be worse, since it'll be everyone.
Anna is with Gael right now, and he will take care of your daughter for sure. You're just not used to seeing Anna all grown up. She has a boyfriend now. Just admit it, son, that you're afraid that eventually Anna might get married soon.
Time flies, right, Mother? I used to make her happy just by buying her banana fritters. It's that simple. Now someone else is making her happy. Someone else is making her smile.
Son, that's just how it is. Because it can't be avoided that she will start a new life without us. I felt the same way when you got married before. Now you already have a family, but I'm still here with you, as always.
Come on, Mother. I'll always be here. You know me very well. Forever a mama's boy, right? I'll always be your boy.
Let's do it, Miss Samantha.
Let's go.
Hey, girls, come on, let's dance.
Hi.
Come on, let's dance. Anna, come on, dance.
Being right, look.
Anna, come on.
No, I'm fine, I'll stay here.
Hey, Anna, join us. Come on, let's dance.
Over here.
Well, Gael, aren't you dancing?
No,
come
you know
on,
I don't dance.
Join us.
Let's dance.
Come on, Anna.
Yes, come up so here.
Just dance.
Keep dancing.
Stay here. Stay here. Come on.
It's okay. Come on.
Come on.
Don't be shy.
Anna!
That's so funny.
Stop recording! Stop it!
That was so embarrassing.
What would you do if that happened?